In the, I was going to say days, but let's go with years, leading up to 2020, I had the pleasure and honor and good fortune to be able to spend time with my dad. I was in the Bay Area. I worked not far from there. So it was really easy to stop by and like make a meal, bring food, or just give him a little hug. And now, like, I'm so thankful for that. And even just to sit by him and pull up a chair and sit next to him, and even if he was resting or taking a nap, just to hear, listen to a person breathe. So at this point, he was like in his room, and then I would sit there, and as I do, put my hand on his shoulder and everything. And I remember, you know, just being like, it's okay, everything's good. And, you know, just there is something about, you know, with everybody, like if you are with a person, you just touch their arm, you know, and they're just, it's more than that. It's energetic exchange, you know. I mean, they're just, as we all know, how to comfort. It's just comfort before the porch. And there's one guy, you know, with a clipboard taking some notations. And then the other fireman is like, you know, can you tell me a little bit about what's going on? And I'm just explaining, well, you know, he rests and, you know, eats the meals and everything. And then, you know, my hand on his head and like on my heart as I usually do if I see him and visit. And then this time, well, because he was stretched on the stretcher, of my hand on his stomach, and just he's so great. And it was so sunny this day. It had been pretty much cloudy all the surrounding days. This day was all super sunny. And the guy, as you know, they're bringing the stretcher down, I would see the sun's all getting in my dad's eyes and everything. And then the one fireman turns to me and beautiful eyes, a smile just coming through him as he goes, he's in good hands. So then when he was at the place, I think it was like Kaiser, South San Francisco, and you know, there are not visitors allowed at this time. Obviously this was beginning of April 2020 and or end of March. And so they're telling me he's doing well. Eating his meals, you know, he's standing up, you know, everything is going well and everything is good. And so we would chat and, you know, thank you, Molly, and I love you too. And just brief conversations to be like, you're doing great. We love you. We appreciate you. Everything's good. Stuff like that. So now he's going to be transferred into like a new facility because he's doing much better and doing well. And they hand me the phone to him. And again, just the usual of you. Everything's good. You're doing great. We appreciate you so much. And he was like, thank you, Melanie. He's like, I love you too, Melanie. And then what it felt like, I mean, I could definitely feel like at my stomach, like wow, like this person is really trying to get something through to me, like he's really saying and like appreciating, perfect. And then I have this great last transmission, and the other synchronicity is the lady of where he was going, you know, was so kind. It was like, we're so happy to receive him. And then the phone call definitely went into, okay, goodbye. Like, and that just totally mirrored and paralleled how he just got there then, you know. And we lovingly bless and honor him.